lipid in the paper. Biochemistry is your third last unit that we have to discuss. So lipid, one of the biomolecule, and in nature this biomolecule could be seen in the different form as butter, mustard oil, ghee, wax, as a part of biological membrane, hormones, as insulation for vital organisms, and as the most important energy storage compound. It means that in your surrounding, in our surrounding, we could see lipid in different forms in our daily routine, as butter, what we use during our breakfast, during any meal, one of the tastier integral part of our meal. The ghee that we use to cook our meal, and the mustard oil also, that is one of the integral part of our daily routine in the kitchen. And as a part of biological membrane, that is biological membrane basically made up of two important components, that is lipid and protein. And this collectively in toto gives the typical structure to the biological membrane, and in turn the different biochemical and physiological aspects to the biological membrane. Hormones, one of the chemical that is responsible for the growth, for the development, for the differentiation of our body from the fetus to the mature form, either in our case or in animal or in plants. And as insulation for vital organisms, and as the most important energy storage compound. So if we are having fat, then definitely it could provide us energy via its oxidation. When we discuss the nature of the lipid, we see that when we consider the biochemical aspect of the lipid, and in order to know its nature, this is actually a heterogeneous group of organic compounds and not polymers. It seems that a triglyceride is having a glycerol molecule plus three fatty acids, so it should be a polymer. But this is not the polymer, because there is no repetition of a single monomer unit. Second characteristic feature that we are having with lipids is that this is insoluble in water. It floats over the water because it is lighter than water, but this could easily be soluble or mixed into organic solvents like alcohol, acetone, etc. This is an excellent insulator for our body. When we talk its physical nature, the pure fat is colorless. It doesn't have any color, odorless, no smell, and tasteless. So could we see the fat in this form? No, because when we think about the butter, this is of cream yellow in color. So what is thing that imparts its yellow coloration? The yellow color of butter or any other fat is due to the mixing of foreign particles that could be easily soluble in the fats. As in case of butter, the carotene is present in the butter that imparts the yellow color to the butter. Now, second characteristic feature that we are knowing, this may be either liquid or solid physically at the room temperature. Now, what is the form that could be seen in the form of liquid? The mustard oil is liquid at room temperature, while on the other hand, the pure ghee is basically solid at the room temperature during the winter season, or coconut oil is solid at the room temperature during winter. So what is the fact that gives the physical form liquid on one hand and the solid on the other hand? So definitely some biochemical thing is there that could impart the different forms of the lipid in different states. When we consider the biochemical nature of the lipid, it is made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen elements. And a typical lipid is made up of two molecules, that is glycerol, which is where three carbons are having attached hydroxyl group and hydrogens, and fatty acids, which is with hydrocarbon chain plus acid group, attached acid group. Now these fatty acids may be either saturated, that is no double bonds are there in between two carbon atoms, or may be unsaturated, that is double triple bonds may be there between the carbon atoms. So again, coming to the lipid, back to the lipid, a lipid is basically known as triglyceride in the triglyceride. Why triglyceride? Because it is having one glycerol with three fatty acids. These are the esters of glycerol plus fatty acids, where one glycerol molecule is being esterified or condensed with three fatty acids. Now these three fatty acids may be either same or different. Depending on the nature of fatty acids, it seems that if glycerol is common, then the second molecule, this is the fatty acid, which is either same or different, imparts the different states of lipid. And now these fatty acids with glycerol, which is known as triglyceride, is collectively known as lipid. And this lipid may be of three different types. Simple lipid, where on one hand we could see either fats and oils, and on the other hand we could see the waxes. Waxes very hard, while oil soft, very soft, slippy, and fats, they are comparatively solid than the oils. Now these fats and oils, which are two different form of simple lipids, on hydrolysis gives fatty acid plus glycerol. And now this fat may be, why there is fat and oil, if both on hydrolysis gives fatty acid and glycerol, then the fats are actually having saturated fatty acids, while on the other hand oils have unsaturated fatty acids. So this unsaturation gives, or unsaturation means presence of double bonds between carbon atoms, imparts the liquid nature to the lipid, while saturation imparts the solid nature to the lipid. On the other hand, when we consider the harder form of the lipid, that is wax, actually this gives fatty acid and long chain alcohol on hydrolysis. So now we are having an idea that the lipid could exist in three different forms: totally liquid like, that is oil, harder than the liquid, that is fats, then most hardest, that is waxes. So we are having three broader categories till now of the lipids: oil, liquid, fats harder than oil, and waxes hardest one. And these are the three types of the simple lipids. It means up to this discussion, it is very clear that since glycerol is common, so in case of fats and oils, so this is the fatty acid that could be responsible for the different states of lipid. So now we will have an idea of the fatty acids. Now this fatty acid is present in a triglyceride along with the trihydroxyglycerol. So besides the trihydroxyglycerol, we are having the fatty acids that could be basically of two types, saturated and unsaturated. The saturated fatty acids, this has no double bonds between carbons and all the valences of carbon are saturated literally by hydrogen. This saturated fatty acid is solid and this is of animal origin mostly, and this fatty acid is having a straight chain of carbons. While in case of unsaturated fatty acids, double bonds are there between carbons and this is liquid at the room temperature, and this is of plants origin in nature basically. The chain is bended where the double bond is present. The second major category of lipid is the compound lipid that could be basically categorized into three different major categories: phospholipid, glycolipids, and the third one is sphingolipids. The phospholipid on hydrolysis gives fatty acid, glycerol plus phosphoric acid plus an alcohol, that is alcohol with nitrogen. The example is lecithin and cephalin. The second category of the compound lipid is glycolipids, which on hydrolysis gives fatty acids plus sphingosine or glycerol plus carbohydrate. The word glycolipid, glyco, is for carbohydrate. The third category is sphingolipids, which on hydrolysis gives fatty acids plus sphingosine plus phosphoric acid and alcohol. So dear students, till this discussion we are having the knowledge of lipids up to the category compound lipid. The third one is steroid. So now we are having the knowledge of the lipid, its form, its nature, its biochemical composition, which is the triglyceride, where one glycerol molecule is being esterified with three fatty acids. Fatty acids may be same or different. That's why they are heterogeneous in nature, and depending on the saturation and unsaturation of fatty acids, we could have the different categories of lipid, that is our oil, fat or waxes, and due to presence of some other chemicals besides the fatty acid and glycerol or long chain alcohols, we are having compound lipids, where that could be categorized in three broader category, and the last one is steroids. In the next coming session, we will discuss the chemical nature of the or chemical properties of the lipid and its oxidation. Thank you.